Yeah. So, hello to everybody. I will speak on very applied simulation. So, then the question to which I will address my talk is how to calculate the flow at very high Reynolds number with the access to the flow at subrisk scale. Okay, so that's why I will. I will speak about the LES approach, but complemented with the stochastic subgrid acceleration model. Okay, so and let me start with the famous washing machine experiment, where in between two contra-rotating disks, the light particle of polystyrene was emerged, and then Nicolas Mordan, Michael Bourguin, and all this team from École Normale of Lyon, they observed the observed the behavior of the particle. And what they've seen, it is really events of real violent velocity increment. For example, here, and 1 millimeter, almost 1 millimeter, and there is 40 meters per second of velocity increment. So, and after, the particles follow with the constant velocity, and then after again, very huge acceleration, and after, like the particle was grabbed by demon, and then withdrawn, and then again grabbed, and it was the signature of the large-scale structures. So and. They calculated the acceleration distribution. They find the heavy tails in distribution of acceleration. Also, the rapid decorrelation of acceleration itself because of this change of the orientation and the long memory for the norm of acceleration. And so in the scenario was that the fluid particles is grabbed by the vertical structures, and then it starts to rotate, but conserving the norm following the structure. So we need to simulate this flow. We know that there is no way to simulate it by Navier-Stokes instantaneity, non-Navier-Stokes equation. Since in application you have very high Reynolds number, and at the same time, when you filter Navier-Stokes equation, the small scale discarded, and so and our concern is to combine LES with subgrid scale model, but accounting for the effect of intermittency, and to find. You should choose the key variable for the subgrid model, and the acceleration is the most appropriate variable because acceleration is the force per unit mass. And also, if you apply the very classical estimations, the ratio of non-resolved acceleration towards the filtered one, then you see the part of non-resolved acceleration is growing with the Reynolds number. And so we decided to use the acceleration as a key variable since it depends on Reynolds number and it is more natural to construct the subgrid scale model on the acceleration. And this experimental result, that means that fast decorrelation on time of Kolmogorov scale of the acceleration and the long memory for the acceleration itself, it can be represented by such a simple model, And you see here the acceleration is relaxated by integral time, while the velocity and while the acceleration is relaxated by Kolmogorov scale. And here there is a Wiener 3D process. And so that means that direction and norm are weakly correlated here. And then using Itô calculus, you can easily come to this expression for the increment of the correlation between acceleration and velocity. And then in stationary case, this is zero. And Kolmogorov scale is much less than integral scale. And you come to the famous Oberkopf diffusion coefficient in the space of velocity. Okay, so that means that all this, despite the many papers and the new physics announced and so on, in fact, all those results confirm the Kolmogorov-Oberkopf theory. So and. We proposed a few years ago in 2011, then for channel flow 2013 and 2011 also the approach LES-SAM. And the idea, very shortly, I will remind the idea. Here is the instantaneous equation, the continuity equation. You decompose this Navier-Stokes equation on the filter part and fluctuating part. This is the filter part. This is the fluctuating part. Nothing new on the west. Yeah. Then you should here have the model. No problem. The model exists since Magarinsky. You replace this nonlinear term by the Boussinesq approximation and with Magarinsky form. Another equation is also cumbersome to resolve because we don't know neither fluctuating pressure, neither fluctuation Laplacian. So another model is to replace this equation by this equation, and I left the pressure gradient term to concern the solenoidity, and I introduced the stochastic model here, okay, the acceleration here. So the sum of this equation will no more the our instantaneous equation. Well, before modeling, the sum will of those equations will represent the instantaneous equation of Navier-Stokes equation. So now you addition these two equations. You say that left-hand side is the acceleration of some hypothetical flow field or reconstructed velocity field. Okay, then this is the pressure which satisfied the solenoidality, and the last is to replace the filtered strain rate by the strain rate of this reconstructed velocity field. The question is how to simulate the acceleration which comes from here. So this is the model equation, which we call a stochastic Navier-Stokes equation, as a sum of two proposals. And it should be completed by the acceleration, the model, on subgrid scale. So since the experiment shows that direction of acceleration and amplitude, they are weakly correlated, then we consider two stochastic processes independently, one for the norm and another for the orientation vector. It's a unit vector given which gives the orientation of acceleration. For the norm of the acceleration, we use the Kolmogorov Obukhov 41. Done in 61, Obukhov proposed the log normal conjecture after the log normal conjecture of Kolmogorov in 1949. He proposed for the cold particles, and then Obukhov proposed the log normal conjecture for epsilon. And then Pope proposed the stochastic equation for the epsilon from this log normal process. And using Itô transformation, we could very easily to write the stochastic equation for the norm of acceleration. It was used in the recent, in the current LES-SSAM approach, and the direction was just sampled from once from the Kolmogorov timescale. So that means that real correlation we replaced by the stepwise function. And there are two shortcomings in this approach which poisoned us our life. Yeah. The first one, in fact, for the box turbulence, there is no supplementary dissipation on subgrid scale, because the subgrid scale just accepts what's going on from the large scale and doesn't create another dissipation. And when you calculate epsilon and this correlation which gives epsilon on subgrid scales, it should be zero, since the older dissipation in the budget of the kinetic energy comes from here. And it was not the case. What not the case? For the wall flow, it may be, because the dissipation can be created, the acceleration can be created on very small scales closely to the wall. So this is the first shortcoming. And another shortcoming is that directed sample directly, randomly at each Kolmogorov time scale. It's not physically, because there is no correlation between along the trajectory of particle. So the naturally, the idea comes to write the stochastic equation for the unit vector for the direction of the acceleration on the unit sphere. This is the stochastic equation. But if you multiply it by E, and you will see that this equation conserved the norm with time, no problem. But practically, Wiener process is the explicit process. And so practically, it is very difficult to conserve the norm during the stochastic simulation for this equation. It was our second challenge to do, and I will speak about this. So the first proposal, how to avoid the dissipation on subgrid scale. We just replaced the modeled acceleration by its projection on the normal on the plate, which is normal to the vector. Yeah, and so this tensor assures the projection from I to the normal projection. So then you see there is no more dissipation on subgrid scales. Okay. The second proposal, to write the Ornstein-Uhlenbeck process for the vector on unit sphere. You write according to the definition of the increment of the velocity of the orientation of the acceleration, you write in the framework of Ito calculus the definition for components of this unit vector. You show that if you calculate this, that the norm is conserved of the unit vector. This is really very simple linear equation, but to which process does it correspond? And you can show, going from Stratonovich to Ito calculus, that it comes to the Ornstein-Uhlenbeck process in the Ito calculus. But you see, it is nonlinear stochastic equation. So that's why it will be very difficult to calculate by Ito calculus this equation. So we used the Stratonovich form for this equation, and we proposed the midpoint scheme. There is a midpoint solution in the matrix form, and then the second step, you update this value by the implicit step, calculating covariant elements, determinant, and so on. So now here you see the conservation of the amplitude of the orientation. There is a correlation function. The PDF is relaxing towards uniform distribution of the PDF of orientation. And what are the results? So first of all, the statistics of fluid particles in the box turbulence. The evident result, the expected result, the budget of the kinetic energy. And this remark was given by Philip Spallard. I'm happy now to reply to him that it is zero. Now you see it is zero. The second, you see here the distribution of the probability, the stretched tails, large eddy simulation comes up to here and doesn't present the tails. And the Bose model, previous and revisited of LAS-SSAM model, gives those tails. And for the amplitude, the PDF is also represented by the new model, while LAS stops here. And this is very important. For example, in combustion, when you have high Reynolds number of flow, then your gradients at small scales can stretch the flamlet and coming to extinction or to reignition. Or, for example, in spray combustion, the particles are of 5-10 microns, and when particles, evaporating particles, is coming across such a violated border, they can be just vapor can be blown up from the droplet. The correlation here is a DNS. Here you see at short time, and this was the goal of the simulation, or short times, the revisited LAS-SSAM model is closely to DNS, and then no difference between two models what is expected. And in fact, it is very closely to the experiment. If you will see here, the experiment is just here, just here. the correlation of the amplitude of the acceleration also the correlation time of order of integral time scale, while here it is of order of Kolmogorov time scale. Here also at short time there is a correlation similar to that from DNS. Now about the statistics of inertial particles, here you can, this is the classical Stokes equation for the particle dynamic. Up is the velocity of particle, Uf is the velocity of flow, and so here you can put either filtered flow or LS, WSAM, or it's the DNS here. DNS. Yeah. So you see here the DNS in continuous line, and empty symbol, it is LUS WSAM, and classical standard approach represents the filled circles. So, and we see that at low Stokes number, the new approach gives this distribution with heavy tails in PDFs of acceleration. The same is the case. In the correlation, also they at short time they correlated with DNS, and then they joined the standard LS. The same for correlation of the acceleration. And so, and there is a hope that to apply it, because it is really very simple to apply it, this approach to the industrial computation. So it is the hope that the access to the small scale structure, which is depending on the local Reynolds number, may be captured in the industrial computation. So.
Mm-hmm. But still you have the constant in the Smagorinsky closure. Yeah. How is important that constant? Because this is something that the people we didn't like anymore, the LES, because there was another constant mm-hmm. that we don't want the constant.
Yeah, we don't want the constant. So, yes,
but
yeah,
then
yeah.
You have the constant.
No, no,
yes,
no, no.
In
no,
the Smagorinsky closure.
I think that if there is a model better than Smagorinsky, it can be used here without any problem. I'm speaking here, the additional trick to Smagorinsky model, it is to go inside to downward to small scale, to subgrid scale. And there I have no constant, only because the local Reynolds number is the parameter, and local Kolmogorov's acceleration is the parameter. Sure, in those two definitions, there are constant, but classical one. There is no paradise on the left, so you should calculate and see what's going on.